How's everybody doing today? I just drove down that about a half a mile back into a field. Another pretty good sized field right there. Yeah, I came on down the farmer's road bed here. The old car didn't struggle too bad. Done pretty good actually. I hope everybody's doing well out there. I feel pretty good today. If you can hear the leaves crunching under me, ooh, it finally looks like fall has gotten here. That right there is another indicator for us. This field back here behind me is full of winter wheat. And I want to try to stay away from that. I've been to this site before with my camping partner Brad, and he wanted to do a camp down here on the creek. Well, I did too. So it looks like today I'm going to take that opportunity. I don't know how I'm going to stake out. Everything under these leaves is rocks there, ladies and gentlemen. But someone built a fire pit down here. Early on in spring, in places down through here, there's pools of water 3 feet deep. But right now, as you can see, not a drop of water to be found. Someone come down and cut some trees down. Cut the tops out of them anyway. There's a little bit of firewood laying around, plus I have some. See the old hot rod hanging there. I'm going to swing between these little maple trees right here. I'll stick around. I don't know how this is going to turn out, but we'll find out here in a little while. Well, I gotta say that setting up down in a creek is quite a bit different than setting up in the woods somewhere. I'm learning how to use rocks. I think I picked a pretty decent place. So far it seems pretty nice. Kinda got my back to the northwest a little bit. And I hope it's going to be a pretty decent night. The weatherman said about 39 degrees. So down here in this bottom, it might be a few degrees colder. I don't know. We're going to find out though. I'm going to take a little break, and then I'm going to clean out that fire pit and get it ready to go tonight. Man, what a beautiful afternoon. Right around 70 degrees. On its way down, hopefully, to the high 30s tonight. Feels pretty good right now, though. Probably 10-15 mile an hour wind coming across. I'm set up facing southeast. Everything's supposed to be coming from that way tonight, if it's going to come at all. No rain. That was supposed to be yesterday, but it didn't happen yesterday either. Which is okay. Ground's still plenty moist. Haven't cleaned out the fire pit yet. That's coming up next. Just took me a little break to sit here and enjoyed the view for a change. Thinking about a few times being down on creek beds, hanging out. And like I said, this is the first time I've ever actually camped in a creek bed. So we're going to see what that's like hammock style. I think I'm going to get to that fire pit, get it done. And give you guys a look around down here. It's kind of nice, kind of nice. Got a pretty good sized field right back over here behind me. Probably going to be some deer out there, I hope. I'd like to see some anyway. I'm going to be quiet. So I'll come back in a little bit. And it'll be a while before I get a fire going, but at least I'll have a clean pit to start with. Stick around. Not a bad little spot. Didn't take too long to get that cleaned out. Got up a little firewood there. Plenty for me for a little while. Especially if it stays warm. Being visited by crows. Seems like a pretty nice place to wake up to. I don't know. I'll walk over and show you guys that field real quick. Yeah, I forgot to mention, when the weather's just right, there's another little creek right here that joins in with this one. I don't know exactly how big this field is. Pretty good size. And I have been back over there in that corner, and once you get to there and kind of make a right, it goes back probably another 100 yards or so. All this fresh winter wheat out here. That's good munching. And it just growed up a little bit over towards the creek bank. And all of a sudden, there I am. I decided to go ahead and pull the flaps down. Well, I suppose it's probably 6 o'clock, something like that. Looking back out there to the west, you can just see it. It's a pretty good sized little hill between me and the lake on the other side. Yeah, just thought it would be nice. Even though it's not very breezy, you can kind of see the flag hanging. Gusting, coming up and down. And I'm ready to get this going. Getting a little bit cooler. I think about 58 degrees. It'll probably drop quick when that sun goes away. Before I strike up this fire here in the creek bed, someone else built a pretty good fire here before. Whoever built the pit probably did, or someone thereafter. They experienced the exploding rocks. I don't think I'm going to have that happen tonight, but I would like to mention Kenny from Ugly Tent Survival and Bushcraft. He made comment of that one time when I was talking about building a fire pit. Don't use the rocks in the creek. They do tend to explode. We got a lot of rock here also that's flint. And it pops and crackles in the fire also after a while. So before it gets too cool, see if I can get a little fire going. And pick something to eat. Gonna be simple tonight. Something like can of soup. I brought some bacon with me. The pre-cooked kind. I may mix a couple of strips of that in with the chicken noodle soup just for a little extra flavor. You guys hang around. Got enough of a fire now to steal me a nice warm chunk and heat up my soup. Pulled apart 5 strips of that bacon, mixed it in with the soup. I'm gonna have some crackers to go along with it. I think it'll go pretty good tonight. Really don't think it's gonna get as cold as they said it was going to. Right now the wind shifted around, blowing right back into the camera. It's coming more out of the north, and just a slight breeze. I could actually feel the warmth of the fire there when the wind died down all the way back up under the tarp. Felt pretty good, actually. I'm not going to build no huge fire tonight. No exploding rocks. And I'm just going to mess around here and get a bite to eat. If you folks haven't tried that chicken noodle soup with bacon in it, might ought to give it a shot. Pretty tasty. I use whole wheat crackers too. Fire feels pretty good right now. I haven't looked at the thermometer lately, but I'm going to say high 40s. I'm just going to kind of let this burn on down. Not going to try to keep a fire going much tonight. Feel like I'm going to be comfortably warm anyway. Brought the same apparatus I used last time, so I should be comfortable. I've already heard a couple of coyotes way far away sounding. Crickets are up tonight. Not bad. Not bad. This little creek bed so far is making a pretty decent place to camp. You can house several folks around here, several flat spots for tents. It's a real shame we just can't enjoy this kind of peace and quiet and a little bit of tranquility just about every night. That would be nice. I've been pretty lucky so far to be able to keep coming camping. I hope the winter continues on good. I may come back to this spot sometime this winter. Right now, I wanted to get down to the lake today. The water is at Winter Pool, which is 354. And I just wanted to show you guys what it was, you know, like when the water's way out. One of the reasons this creek is dry. But at some point in time, the water will be running down through here. Where I'm sitting would be about a foot deep of water. I'll try to come down and get some shots of that. I'll have to walk in because you got to cross two little creeks that'll be running then also. And at that point in time, the water will be back up down at the lake. Like it was in my earlier videos, the Byrd Bay video. I stopped down there today, thought I might do that one again, and there was a young couple down there, very nice, just them and their dogs. They were still setting up, so I came out, and I went up to the end of 210 where I had pretty much planned on camping, and there was a nice party of three camping there. Couple of gentlemen and their lady friend. Nice young folks. So I just kind of wandered around a little bit, and you know, this was kind of on the way back, so I thought I'd give it a try, and I'm kind of glad I did. Kind of glad I did. Probably have to get out and gather up a little bit of wood tomorrow. There's some downed trees downstream from here. The creek does run this way from my left to right. When there's water here. Speaking of water. Yeah, somewhere over here.
Yeah, there it is. A little shot of not water tonight. I can't remember all the names of my new subscribers. I'm going to try to run some credits at the end. I appreciate everybody watching, for sure. I just come out and like to have a nice, peaceful time sitting here. Yeah. Even if I had a friend or two, it would still be nice and peaceful, but somehow it's just not the same as parking your arse out here in a creek in the middle of the night by yourself. So, here's to all my new subscribers tonight. Thank you. Thanks everybody else for watching. Pretty good vintage there also. Pretty tasty tonight. Got a little piece of a moon going away quick. Caught a glimpse of it earlier today. See a few stars starting to twinkle out. That'll be nice tonight. Gonna be clear. We can only hope it gets down kind of cool. Well, I may be here another night or so. We'll see what tomorrow brings. Might just get up with the urge to go camp somewhere else. I don't know. I'm thinking here's probably a pretty good spot to stay, though. So I'll talk to all you guys again in the morning. Yeah, pretty basic cooking this morning. I waited a little bit, let the sun come on up. This feels good. Temperature's come up a bit. Got me some eggs there. Some bacon. Piece of whole wheat flatbread. Yeah, put a couple of strips of bacon down there in the cup. I'm just cooking simple this morning. Everything in the cup. I should get a few bushcraft points there for making a twig toaster. It works. As you can see, it was time to get rid of the sweatshirt. My temperature indicator says it's 66 degrees out now. And it's a little after noon. Not sure. Shadows are falling to the east already. Feels good. Feels real good. Didn't do anything special. I did tighten up the underquilt, bring it up a little tighter underneath me. Maybe that'll help tonight. And while I was eating breakfast there earlier, I heard something back over here in the field, heard a familiar sound. And I grabbed the camera and started walking over that way, and I spied, I got to count, 13 turkeys. And as I was trying to set the tripod up and get a shot, because I'd have had to zoom in, one of them evidently seen me. And, so I'm guessing that gray and black don't make good camouflage out here this time of year. But they scurried off into the woods. I think I'm going to take a little hike down this way and check out the firewood situation. It's nice to know if you're going to try to winter camp somewhere. Got firewood there already and don't have to mess around and bring any with you. That's kind of nice. So I'm going to walk down the creek bed. Why don't you guys come with me? Yeah, you can see there I'm set up in a little depression area. Somebody already had the fire pit built. Couldn't pass that up. Not a bad looking little campsite though, huh? I wish I could have caught those turkeys. I've never seen them in any numbers, so to speak, down here. You see, you know, maybe five or six of them together, but
Generally, I never do see that many at one time. I guess I should have been a little bit stealthier, huh? Look at there, Robert E. Lee Natural Bridge. Oh, look at here, guys. In a survival situation, wouldn't that be a sweet find? Ooh-wee. Little black got some tannin in it from the oak trees and maples, I guess, maybe put off a little tannin. This one down here, that's a maple. Looks like it fell this year. Still had little leaf buds on it. Just lost its root ball. Unfortunately on this, I don't know whether the camera will pick it up well or not. You see that oily scum there? Maybe it's just my polarized glasses, but it's got oil in it. This is the one I'm going to capture some firewood from. I'm going to mosey on down around the corner. There's another one. This one's a bit bigger. Ooh, and I saw a couple of minnows out there. Means there's probably a fish in that rascal somewhere. I'm kind of curious whether there'll be any deep spots left. We haven't had an overabundance of rain. But when the lakes get down, the whole water table around here drops as far as creeks and streams. Finding rocks like this down here is pretty common also. I hope you can see all the fossils. Not sure what they are. Some kind of shellfish looking thing. And we have a lot of rocks like this around here too. That's a seam of quartz. Very volcanic area at one time, I think. When I say volcanic area, eons and eons ago, I suppose now. But a gentleman who I trusted for his studies told me that the rocks that look like this, looks like this on the outside, and look like this on the inside, are a product of volcanic activity. I don't know, I just always thought it was neat. Big old round rocks, you know. This is a good example of here what happens when the water does get up in here. It definitely found the path of least resistance around these trees. Nice little pond there. I bet it's got fish in it of some sort. Most of these little creeks and streams around here have bluegills. You see those little swirlies on top of the water there? It's a dark. I can't even see under the surface of it. But when I walked up, they quit hitting the top of the water. You see how it just kind of eats its way around. Another indicator right there, just how high the water can get coming around through this little creek. I got the camera about head high out in the creek bed. So the water's been at least 5 feet, maybe even 6 feet deep coming around this corner at one time. Strange looking twin. I don't think like a survivalist, but I think if I were thinking that way, I see a whole lot of opportunities here to make a nice little spot for getting warm, just getting out of the weather in general. All the way down that bank there, it's a nice little cozy spot to boat up against. Oh, looks like somebody's camping down there. Wait a minute. That's me. Yeah, I just guess that goes to prove that everywhere I go, there I am.
It's about 5:30. Been kind of overcast this afternoon. Just hung out in the hammock. Crickets have come out early. And it won't be long. The sun will be behind the trees over there anyway. So I thought I'd go ahead and get a fire going. I'm only going to burn for a while tonight. I don't want to have a big pile of coals first thing in the morning to deal with. I'd like for it to pretty much be out. I went down and decided not to take any off of that maple tree down there. I just picked some stuff up around, some fallen limbs, smaller stuff. I had a few more pieces of that poplar in the trunk. I'm going to go ahead and burn it tonight and get this going. 58 degrees here in the camp. Somewhere around 14, 15 degrees Celsius, something like that. No, I didn't do the math. My little thermometer did. Feed the fire just a little bit at a time when it first gets going instead of throwing on a whole bunch of sticks. To me, it's a little more methodical, a little more making the fire instead of rushing the fire. Yeah. I'm going to have a simple dinner tonight, so I'm not going to need much fire anyway.
Doesn't get much simpler than that. Pack of pork flavored ramen, fruit and grain bar, bottle of water. Got some gummy bears I'll probably chew on later.
Was trying to get a little earlier start on the campfire session, but got dark on me a little quicker tonight too. It's funny how that does that out in the woods. And glad you guys are joining me here the second night. About 48 degrees already. Sun went away, didn't take long. There's been several people mentioned on my comments that how peaceful it is. I'm glad I'm able to portray that, because that's what I come out here to seek. And this is just what it's all about, you know? There's a saying amongst the old Harley-Davidson people, if I have to explain it, you won't understand. And I feel very much that way about coming out like this, by myself or with somebody else. It's nice to have company out in the woods. Mark, Y Explorer, you portray a very peaceful man yourself. Gornism, there out of Oklahoma, I feel you to be pretty much on the same plane I am. Yeah. I don't have to be totally left alone, but it's nice to have these moments where I am totally alone. It's hard to find kindred spirits, you know.
enjoyed this day. Really did. Nice little walk. Here again on these survivalist type thing, and a dry creek bed offers a whole lot of places to get out of the weather and to get warm. Well, I'd like to say aloha to my friend Lynn in Hawaii. I know he'll watch. Come around Thanksgiving time. Oh, way back in about 87, I think, is when Lynn and I met. He may not remember, but I kind of do. We had a lot of good times together. One very unsuccessful net fishing trip there off the north shore of Oahu. I was pretty sure that he was going to drown me before it was over with. Didn't catch no fish either, best I remember. But it was a good day altogether. Another adventure. Tonight, Lynn, this one's for you. Can't really store that stuff too close to the flyer, you know. Well, I think I'm going to call it an evening. Just kind of sit around. Heard a little owl a while ago. See if it continues on. Other than that, right now, it ain't nothing but crickets. Kind of nature's little radio, huh? All right, everybody. I'll catch up with you in the morning. Hopefully have a nice night. Readjusted the underquilt. We'll see how that goes. Good night. Good morning. 37 degrees this morning. Yeah, low 40s again. Strange how that happens. It's kind of cool here in the camp feeling. I don't got no fire going this morning. I let it go out. I've already got it buried and covered up for the day. It's good. Got my little biofuel stove going here, heating me up some water so I can have my Swiss Miss and oatmeal this morning. And I'm just going to kind of slowly strike camp and head back to civilization. Had a really thought-gathering time.
extremely peaceful. Just hope I got enough tranquility built up to deal with society for another week. Maybe. I hope so, anyway. Like I said, just gonna mosey about, head back to the house. This was the daylight savings time thing this weekend, so I guess my clock is an hour off still. I'm an hour ahead of everybody. But appreciate you guys coming. Hope you stuck around for the whole thing. Wasn't too bad boring. Tried not to be anyway. I'll try to get another trip together here before long. See if I can't come back down this way. If not, take a weekend at the hideout. Anytime. Once again, thanks for joining me. And until next time, just waiting for the next big adventure.